and not successful.
Right.
You understand? And if you look at, and you see, the thing is that that system would be successful, right, without the crime issue that Jamaica has right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because post the crime issue, which was post Seaga and Manly era, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Jamaica economy was thriving. Jamaica economy was running was growing the same rate as Singapore.
Right.
Right? But as soon as the 80s hit, mm-hmm. where you had that 1980s election, mm-hmm. or mid-70s,
right.
Right, Jamaica economy tank because right. of the crime issue that started happening in Jamaica.
Well, if
but, so, you see, ever since that happened, mm-hmm. Jamaica economy been stagnant.
No, but you see, I remember, and this is something that I remember. You bring up the economy and how the economy moved. I remember as a kid back in Jamaica, right, in the 80s, right, mm-hmm. where Jamaican dollar was one U.S. dollar to one Jamaican dollar, and Jamaica was going. The reason, and we have to talk about the real true reason why Jamaica economy is the way it is.
It's crime.
Crime contributes to it, but I'm gonna tell you what it is. And a lot of people are gonna hear this and then go feeling their feelings, but it's the facts, and you could go look it up. In the 80s, when Edward Seaga came to the US and brought the CIA into Jamaica to destabilize the country. And when they brought them in there because they wanted to win the election, the 80 election. Mm. And after the CIA came in and destabilized Jamaica, one of the agreements that they had was that Jamaica had to become involved with the IMF, the International...
Exactly.
Right? And once Jamaica got involved, and let me tell you something, it's just like if you have your house or you go borrow money from somebody. When you're in debt to somebody, you have to work based upon what... And when the IMF came in, the IMF said to Jamaica, there are certain things that you must do to pay us back this money that we're giving you. And those things that Jamaica started to do, and Jamaica started to start... tanking Jamaica's economy and start causing the economy to go. So the crime then at that point, because the real true crime in Jamaica started in the 80s.
Yeah, that's what that's what I'm saying. Like, it's not entirely the British.
It's not. No, I agree.
Monarch system that's causing it.
I agree that.
You understand? I would say it contributes to it in a way, but for example, that's a big issue with Jamaica economy, the IMF.
Yeah, yeah.
And I have to give Andrew Hones credit. And I have to give Peter Phillips credit, which mm-hmm. is a PMP.
Right.
Peter Phillips didn't want to be prime minister and never wind up being prime minister. Long right. story short.
Yeah.
But Peter Phillips, when he was in power, when Portia Simpson Miller was in power, right? Peter Phillips was the brainchild behind Portia Simpson Miller, in my opinion. Peter Phillips was more the prime minister because Portia cannot run a country.
Okay.
I would just say that.
Okay.
Peter Phillips was the one that was running Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Peter Phillips went into an agreement with the IMF
mm-hmm.
that put Jamaica on this program that managed Jamaica debt. Mm-hmm. And that program is paying off today. Because I remember back in those days, Jamaicans were crying that they have to pay a whole heap of taxes, GCT taxes.
Right, I remember GCT.
Yeah, and they must say, yo, Peter and Portia hit with the taxes, but that was a necessary move to get the country out of debt, because Jamaica GDP, debt to GDP ratio at that time was 149% of GDP.
Right.
And Jamaica got to a point where it couldn't borrow any more money from the IMF or the World Bank because Jamaica credit is bad.
Right.
So now, you know, Peter Phillips went into that program and Jamaica came out of that program right now victorious because Jamaica debt to GDP ratio, the last time I checked, is 95%.
Right, so we're going down.
It's declining. Down. And they say by 2025, it should be 60% of GDP.
Right?
Which, so this is the thing, right? If Jamaica debt to GDP ratio get to 60%,
mm-hmm.
it allows the government to spend more money on social programs.
Right.
Invest into the police.
Agree.
And all that stuff, right?
Agree.
And if the more money the government have,
mm-hmm.
right, the more you will see more more justice being delivered.
Right.
The police getting better, right? And the thing is that currently Jamaica don't have any money.
Right.
Because, you know, debt to GDP ratio is 95%.
Right. So everything you make, you pay back.
Yeah, pay back everything and you only have 5% of your GDP
mm-hmm.
that you can spend on social programs. It's getting better now.
Yeah.
But before it couldn't.
Yeah, right.
And we can talk about why Jamaica get into that situation where debt to GDP ratio was at 49%. And I again, it's not the JLP problem, it's the PNP problem.
Right, right, right.
You understand? Because they borrowed a lot of money.
Right.
And a lot of those money that's borrowed is missing.
Right.
It's corruption.
Well,
if that money was invested in Jamaica, Jamaica would be in a different place, because now the debt, the money that we borrowed would be yielding back.
Right, but here's the thing.
So
when you talk about the money that borrowed, introducing that introducing the IMF into Jamaican system, and not that Jamaica didn't know at the time that any country that the IMF go into and borrow money from them get screwed. Why you think? Okay, let me tell you something. The IMF they're here in America, right? The IMF is here in the US, right? Why you think? And the money that they, let's get clear, the money that they're lending is not from America money, you know. Why you think America don't come to the IMF and say, yo, we borrow money? Where they go? They can go China.
Mm.
Why do you think that? And why do you think that with China coming into Jamaica and spending? See, America is not stupid. And you all got to understand, America play chess when the whole people are playing. Draft. Mm. America play chess.
Mm.
Why do you think Donald Trump and his party, who don't give a crap about Jamaica or whatever happens to Jamaica, when the Chinese went into Jamaica and started building the roads and stuff like that, they went down and says, no, we don't want this to happen.
That's true.
The reason behind it is that here's what happened. Because people think China is poor. China is not poor. Because the United States is borrowing money from China. Here's the thing. If the Chinese government come into Jamaica, because Jamaica has a very important strategic position, where every country, talking about Russia, talking about China, they would like to be in that position, because where Jamaica is located, if they put a foothold in Jamaica, they put a missile base in Jamaica.
Or Cuba.
Right? Or Cuba. That's why they pressure Cuba as much as they do. Then what happens next? American bargaining chip goes down, because we can strike your homeland in 5 seconds. So, hold on. Right?
So, yeah, it's a lot of things. It's a lot to unpack.
Yeah.
Like, this is a lot for me to talk about. But you're talking about, so the reason why the CIA went to Jamaica, right, and why America was interested in the CIA going to Jamaica is because of Cuba. It's because of Cuba.
And the Cuban Missile Crisis, you remember? The
Cuban Missile Crisis, yes. But, so, Michael Manley was best friends with Fidel Castro.
Right.
Right? And America didn't like that. You understand? And because of that, Seaga saw opportunity. Seaga said, well,
in running to America.
So Seaga, absolutely. And guess what? Seaga is not born in Jamaica.
No, he's Syrian.
No, he's born in Boston, Massachusetts.
I thought he was born in Syria.
Nope. Seaga is born in Boston.
That's news. I learned something tonight. Jamaicans always use talking about the Syrian.
Seaga is American. You understand?
Yeah, wow.
So Seaga saw the opportunity, right? And this is the thing with Jamaica. We have to talk a lot about this, because it's the whole Commonwealth thing. That thing is messed up, because Jamaicans, right, anybody from the Commonwealth can be a member of Jamaica Parliament or become Prime Minister. As long as you're a Commonwealth citizen, you can be Prime Minister. In theory, a Jamaican can go to England and be a MP in England or Canada. Because there was a case with a Canadian guy run for office in Jamaica and became MP with his Canadian citizenship.
He had to renounce his citizenship. No. Wasn't there something
behind that? That's Darrell Vaz.
That had to renounce his American citizenship.
Yes, that's Darrell Vaz, because America is not a part of the Commonwealth.
Mm.
But if you're a part of the Commonwealth where the Queen is the head of state, you can actually like run without, you know.
Which don't make sense.
Yeah, it don't make no sense. If you're a Jamaican.
Jamaican, run for Jamaica.
Run for Jamaica. Your
interest is going to be different.
Yeah, exactly. So with this case with Seaga, right? I believe Seaga probably gave up his, well, those are the back in the days type of thing. I doubt that he gave up his American citizenship.
So we have to look.
Yeah, we have to look up that.
Now that you tell me that, I'm going to research it. Because I really want to dig a bit deeper into that.
But Seaga, right? Seaga he saw the opportunity at the time to get into power.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, well, let me go talk to Ronald Reagan and get the CIA to come to Jamaica and destabilize the country.
And then me put it back together.
People, if you go up online and watch this movie called Countryman,
yeah,
that movie tell you about the CIA and invading Jamaica, because that movie talk about this plane flying over Jamaica and crash, and then the Jamaican military look for them and can't find them. And that movie is just sending a message about how the CIA used to come at Jamaica, drop plane, fly over, drop a plane with gun. And gone.
Yeah.
The agents, they used to come and give guns to the youth them, and that's how you start having the crime and violence in Kingston.
Well,
but look, that's a long
And more than just that, there is a program on ABC. Anybody that know it, because this is how I became aware of a lot of this stuff. On ABC, there was this program that called Like It Is, right? And it would I forgot what the guy's name is. And he was the first one to kind of, because I never knew this stuff. And when he put it out there, I started to look into it, and I'm like, wow,
all right,
this is how it is.
A good movie you can watch to is Life and Death. Life and
Death. Guys, real quick,
dead yet.